Cheers, lad, Barra.
Thank you.
Sit down.
I'll get some of those nails and we'll get some nails in.
Carrying the bucket of concrete is testing the concrete's consistency to make sure it's right.
Thank you.
another one.
I've got a bit stuck.
You may remember before we had our kitchen done, we had an American style fridge freezer. We replaced them with the built-in, but we're taking the old fridge freezer, not that it's very old, to our holiday lets that we have in Whitby. We've hired two young men and a white van to take it to Whitby and carry it up the stairs for us.
Fridge freezer is arriving.
And that's where it's going, up there. I hope it fits. Yeah, so might be a bit tricky because it's very heavy. Well, it took some doing, but we all pitched in and managed to get it up the stairs into the corridor, along the corridor to the kitchen. And the kitchen door was just too narrow to get it in. Rens had brought his tools with him just in case, so he managed to take off the door casing so we could get the fridge freezer through. The guys took the old fridge freezer down to the tip for us. Next day, Rens went back to Whitby to put the door casing back on, so it's all lovely now. Sorry there's no pictures, but I was so busy helping, I didn't have time. That's the pump for the endless pool, which is in the garage.
From the leftover concrete, they made a nice little concrete path to our hay and pallet shed, which will prove to be very, very nice in this winter. Gravel path is finished now. Concrete base for deck room is all hardened now and ready to receive its stack room somewhere in January. And this is the concrete where the washing spot for the horses is. In front of the stables, it's just been laid today and it will take another couple of days to really set, but it will all be great.
Hope you'll join us tomorrow to find out what happens when concreting doesn't go quite according to plan. TTFN.